feel like they have to squat down, and I'm not very tall. Thank you so much for coming out this evening. We would like to thank you also for allowing your students to come and practice not only during the school day, but after school for many hours. They have spent a lot of time on this evening's performance, and I hope you enjoy it. And I'd like to introduce Mrs. Fidler, our music and drama teacher.
Good evening, everyone. I want to thank you so much for giving me the gift of working with your wonderful children. They are amazing, and it's such a gift to get to work with them every day. You might have seen some posters directing you down the hall. If you didn't, that's okay. Afterwards, we invite you to see some of the work that your children have done. They have been exploring some of the civilizations that you will hear about briefly tonight in our performance. So if you after the show, we invite you to go to the hall directly behind us where the music room is, and you can see some of the work they've done exploring the ancient civilizations and the letter they've written to their future self. So we hope you enjoy the show, and let's get ready to dig in.
Can friends yapping.
Well, what do you expect, Taki? Most of them have heads the size of a baseball. But there still is a lot we can learn from them about the past. Good question, Tuck. Those are the Sumerians from the land of Mesopotamia. What you're looking at there is pretty typical of 2000 BC. That guy is the famous Gilgamesh.
People, people, work with me now. We've got to work together.
Who died of it, Hinky?
I heard that. Now look, I know you're all used to working independently and getting along just fine. But it's 110 degrees out here, and this land is as dry as a desert.
No. Sir! Sir! Sir!
What is it, I can move my valley to find it, sir?
It is a desert.
Okay, so it is a desert. But if we just get along, but if we just work together a little bit, I think we can survive here. And maybe even create one of the first great civilizations.
Gilgamesh is right, everyone. Working together, we can make sure no one messes around Mesopotamia.
Well put, Emerson. Well put.
Thank you, sir.
Now, we've got rivers on both sides of this planet. And what are they called?
Rivers!
I know that, but what are the names of these rivers?
The Tigris and the Euphrates.
A plus. They've allowed our production of farm goods to go way up. So, what's the problem?
The problem, sir, is that we need a more efficient way to transport these goods to market.
Right, right. Right you are. Well, who's got a suggestion?
Sir, if my flex suggests, I've been working on a small, round invention that I think might have great possibilities.
I can't see it myself, but we'll go ahead and give it a try. What's next?
Well, sir, I've been working on a system of currency that I think might help us keep track of what we trade and what we owe.
A capital idea! Write it down.
Write it down!
Write it down, sir?
Figure it out, Enkidu. I can't do everything. I'm so proud of you all. At this rate, we should be able to build a civilization that lasts for thousands of years, right here between our own two beautiful rivers.
Rivers flow, makes things grow, living
so alive.
Alive?
Well, we'll see about that. Listen up, here comes King Zoser of Egypt and his trusted servant, Imhotep.
Wow, he looks pretty good considering he lived over 4,000 years ago.
King Zoser, grain is scarce.
I've got no grain!
The fruit is all dried up.
Look at my fruit, it's all dried up!
People are so desperate that they're robbing their neighbors.
Wow, look at that.
What?
Children are crying and old people are as sad as can be.
I know. Build me a pyramid.
What?
But first, I must learn the name of the god of the Nile. Then we can offer sacrifices to that god, and he will help us. Everyone, go to sleep at once.
I am Konu. That is K-H-N-U-M. They just sound. I know the River Nile. When it covers the fields, it gives them a lie. Now, the Nile will pour over the land without stopping. Plants will grow bowing down with fruit. The years of starvation will be over. Thank you and good night.
Ladies and gentlemen, my fellow Egyptians, I have had a marvelous and rather brief dream. The name of the god of the Nile is Khnu. That's K-H. Oh, never mind. We must offer sacrifices to them. The years of hunger have ended. Now we can build the great Egyptian civilization that people talk about for generations to come. I know you're hungry, but first things first. So we'll start with a giant pyramid, which shall be my tomb!
Building pyramids. Tut, tut, little tut. Very interesting question. And to help me answer it, let me introduce you to my good and very wise friend, Confucius.
Confucius says, good afternoon, young curious friends of heirs still to come.
Good afternoon, sir.
Confucius says, since you left, I might inform you that when Egypt was flourishing, you and Egypt came together as your own.
Does he always tell me that?
Confucius says, I heard that.
Brilliant teacher some 2,500 years ago.
And he's right. While Egypt flourished in the west, India and the dynasties of China were thriving in the east.
what's the new play about anyways?
It's supposed to be about all the wonderful things of Greece that will be around thousands of years after we're all dead and gone.
That's interesting.
It is interesting, but I can't seem to come up with the right one to tie it all together.
How about the Odyssey?
No, Homer beat me to it.
How about Greece the Musical?
It'll never fly.
How about Greece is the word?
What? What did you say?
Greece! Greece is the word! And give it a good dance crew!
That's it!
Glad you got it!
Far away as Morocco, Iraq, and even England. Wow is right.
And legend says it all started with two brothers and their dream to build a city.
No, Romulus, I'm telling you. I had a dream. And in my dream, I saw six vultures flying over the exact spot where we should build a city.
No, Remus, I too had a dream. And in my dream, I saw 12 vultures flying over the spot where we were found with babies in that basket and raised by that wolf. 12 is more than 6, and so that is where we should build our city.
6 is an omen from the gods. That the spot I chose is red.
12 is a bigger omen.
6.
12.
6.
12.
I'm telling Mom.
What does she care? She's a wolf for Pete's sake. Now I must kill you with this rock.
Oh.
And I'll call it Rome.
Hey, Romulus, how's Rome coming along?
Yeah, Romulus, heard you were having problems with the aqueducts.
Look, guys, it can't be built in a day, you know.
No need to be snippy, Romulus.
I just hope it's ready for Caesar's big bash on Saturday night.
Oh, rats! I forgot all about the big party. Now I have a thing to wear.
Don't worry, Roman number one. The word is out. The dress is my toga, so you're all set.
Togas? Great. I've got a linen closet full of them.
Then what are you waiting for? Let's go!
For those who follow us.
That's awesome!
We matter! So here's to the past, both big and small,
and here's to the future for one and all. I don't really think this is gonna work.
Here's to the memories we pray they'll last.
Thank you for holding this musical, and thank you for making my last performance the best performance I've done. Thank you. You have guided me through my 5th and 6th grade years. Me and you have made them the best. Thank you for all that you have done, and thank you for encouraging me to try new things. And also, thanks for getting these amazing costumes and props.
As you can see, this was an amazing performance as a play, and you couldn't have done it without Fidler, because she helps us get through our lines, make sure we know what we're doing, and do it. So let's give her another round of applause. Yeah.